Good evening, everyone. Tonight I'd like to show you how you can turn even the simplest piece of music into sounding like $1 million. My giraffe, Amadeus, got whiffed of me doing this and asked if he could sit in on the tutorial. So here it is. And this iPad is going to turn really bright when I'm sitting down, so I'll have to reach and touch it, and that'll make it go dark again. Here we are. Anyway, these two pieces, In the Wood by C.J. Thomas and The Fisher Maiden's Song by T.F. Dunhill, were in the Toronto Conservatory book, the old edition. And I used to teach them all the time. And I enjoyed those pieces because there's a beautiful melodic line in each of them. And the bel canto sound, that singing quality of tone, can be achieved in both of these pieces, and yet they're very easy pieces for grade two level. So in this one, In the Wood, it's an andante and it's walking pace and it's melody, it's in the left hand. So that's a little tricky, but if you don't think about that and you just play it as notes, you're gonna get sort of thing. But if you go for the sound, the quality of sound, the difference is not only that you're singing the music, you're singing the melodic line and hearing that the accompaniment isn't overpowering it, but it's how you get the tone. You have to be able to be so relaxed in your arms. You have to be able to flop right through to the floor, and then the key is, it's like this diving board sticking out of a mountain. You come into that diving board, and then if that was board was a piece of chocolate, let's say, you feed on that chocolate. You take it into your soul, into your stomach. So lift, release on the way up, and free fall to gravity. Let gravity bring the weight down, but come down as tenderly as you can. So if you don't think about how tenderly you're coming in, you just play the note and it's cold and it's meaningless, but in the descent, the key will become an energy into the hammer. But if you can think of the key bed, the bottom of the key, as where your weight is, like if you were on the floor, like Christian Zimmerman explained to a student once, to a young boy once that he was giving a master class to, he said, get down on your knees. And just sit down in front of the keys. And the boy did, and he put his hands up to the keyboard. And Christian Zimmerman got him to get the arm, all this relaxed weight, just flopping. Because the boy was holding his weight up, so you can't go from one note to... You can't play it like that and be above the keys. You want to be in the keys so that you're hanging on each one. Then you can crawl to the next and make it as tight a legato as you can. The finger has to be able to go out And then it's like if that was a block of chocolate, it's going to feed on it. It's going to come in like this with your finger. But all the while, you've surrendered to gravity. So this is happening at the same time. So when you... But don't have that too loud. But I do want to hear both of those notes. So while you're going, in the going, ask yourself, will I go here? No, maybe I'll go there. And this kind of question, when you're doing that and questioning yourself, then you become like the composer. Well, maybe I'll write it this way. No, maybe I'll write it that way. And when you start to put that kind of question and answer response into your sound, the listener starts to hear it as a work of a book that they're reading, something, what's going to happen next, the mystery comes out. So this gives you an idea of what makes it sing. You can't just play notes. Sure, it's 3-4 time, and it's 3-1-2-3, tick, 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 tick. But that's just the notes you want to hear. So pause on that one a weeny bit, and then just... So it's not... You see? You ask yourself, well, now that I'm up there, where do I want it to go? I want it to go there. Comes down, breathe, new phrase. Plucking almost, taking, but you're still flopping. You'll get that note to sing more than what you had here. That was just sort of sinking and taking, but when you want up, you want it to speak more, then there's more of a sharpness into the hammer, the energy into the hammer. So I hope that gives you some ideas on that one. Now, this other one, the Fisher Maiden song, the melody's in the right, so it becomes... And it says, with motion, con moto, so. But I don't just play it. I'm voicing, I'm hearing that that's this melody. This is the support, the bass, and the harmony in between is less. See, the piece can be far more meaningful when you can create color in your sound and use the weight touch. So, you see, it just floats. If you pull the fallboard off of the piano, unscrew the cheeks and lift up and lift the lock rail with it and set it over, and then without pressing down on any of the keys, or you smash the hammers off, draw the action out, and take a look at what's happening in there. As you sink into the hammer, into the key, the hammer at the other end of the key, like a teeter-totter, gets thrust up, and it's how it gets sent up to make a sine curve out of that wave that's vibrating from the front of the piano to the back. That's what creates the overtone and the color. But the tip has to be steel, but it's still taking, it's still actively taking, but you're hanging on it, just hang on the key like that and crawl, but think of how tenderly you want the key to go down. You wouldn't throw a baby into the carriage. you lay it in gently. So, but all the weight goes in, but then you have to be able to feed off of that and take like that, like you're just like a tongue licking the bar of chocolate when you're on the key bed as you're flopping. See, you have to have that internal metronome going inside of you all the time. Da, da. But then you can put the rubato, pull back, and if you pull back, then you have to make up and go forward. But feel that you maintain the stability of the tempo that you've chosen, that it doesn't go out of the frame. So I hope that gives you some ideas in terms of how you can take a simple piece and make it sound so special and so full of color, each note in the going, the mystery of the music. And it's very rewarding to play it like that. It doesn't have to be a complicated, difficult piece to be able to get a lot of pleasure out of it. So I hope you can apply some of that to pieces that you're playing and enjoy doing it. It's lots of fun. Have a good night. Bye-bye.